Hey guys, I'm up. I have a very bad tendency to oversleep lately in general. It's like past 10 a.m. and I still need to walk back to the motorbike. And yeah, I still need to pack things and walk to the motorbike. But yeah, anyways, I'm gonna do that. Hang around in Queenstown again, I think. And figure out what to do next. Alright, let's get to work. Considering doing today is go on a Lord of the Ring set hunt, and then have might find a campground outside of Queenstown. Probably will have to pay a little bit, but not too expensive campground, so I can get to Alexandra tomorrow pretty quickly. Trouble with my mic, I don't get why it's pissing me off. So I'm going back to the motorbike the same way I came. I'm almost there, I think. It was a bit faster because it was not getting up, it was mostly getting down. My knee hurts a little bit while getting down, which is weird, but anyways, not too bad. The view were very similar to what I saw yesterday. So there was not much point in shooting B-roll because, you know, you've already seen it yesterday. So yeah, the hut, the little information booth I saw yesterday was right over there. And my motorbike is next to it, so I'm already back to my motorbike, and I'm guessing it's not even 12. No, 11, like 15 past 11, quarter past 11. Not too bad. I'm planning on filming a bit my way back with the drone. There were some beautiful sceneries on that road. That was pretty sketchy, but beautiful. So there's a lot of airplanes and helicopters in this valley that goes around. I'm hearing some engines running down this valley. I understand why, it's beautiful and it must be a blast to take full advantage of it with off-road vehicle. My motorbike is barely off-road, so I'm not taking too much risks. So the track that I did was called the Crystal Track or something like that, and went that way in that valley. There's a bunch of other tracks and other huts. We can see ruins over there. So yeah, this place used to be a big, yeah, like mining place, and I guess quite busy back in the day. And now it's just become a place of leisure and people come. The fact that it's a busy valley is kind of reassuring, because if I run into trouble with the motorbike, which I hope I won't, but you never know. There are people passing by. It's very cold. I'm hesitating. Something, none of them on the top. Just gonna go quickly for a little hike and come back and then check Corona Peak, which is the closest ski resort. So most of the track around here are way too long for me to get started, like 5 or 6 hours. So I'm just came up here to check the view. Those mountains are incredible. Behind there, I think, is Queenstown. Yeah. So yeah, I'm gonna go back down over there, then take a left to reach Corona Peak. Snow cannon and everything. Good thing or bad thing, depending on how you like your snow and whatever. If you ever wonder what a ski resort looks like during the summer, it's pretty desert. The lifts are not working in some places, like Whistler. The lifts are working for the mountain bikers, except for the people doing parapet and the couple of people doing mountain bikes or the couple of tourists that checks the view. Not much happening compared to winter. All right, let's head back to Queenstown. We'll be right back. outside. I'm living busy Queenstown on this beautiful sunset. I'll probably check the sunset from the motorbike. And I'm heading towards Cromwell. There is a campground there, and I'll be in Alexandria tomorrow for the mechanic. Let's go.
Video, but it's okay, I'm sure you won't mind.